So guys, this is HotDog7RCT, and today I bring you the follow-up video that I promised you guys that I would have for you on the Super NES Classic Edition. This time, of course, being hacked to allow for much more games and systems to be played on the system, the SNES Mini or Classic Edition. So yeah, it's been crazy fun having the system so far. As of this time, I'm gonna unplug it here for a second, just so you can see. Hopefully it will not crap out on me. This little baby right here. Yes, so small, so tiny. Now, the appeal that this has for me. Let me bring down the music down here for a second. Alright, the appeal that this has to me is this right here, the controller. This is as close as you're gonna get to a standard SNES controller, because of course it's built by Nintendo. Now, playing these emulated games, even though I know that a lot of you out there must be saying, but why? I mean, why are you so, I don't know, enthralled by this? Let me hook this back up. If it's just emulation, I mean, you have done tons of video on emulation and on Hyperspin and all of these crazy, amazing software programs that you can do on the PC. And you know me, guys, I've covered everything from arcade to, you know, consoles and everything in between. But what makes this one so appealing, and it's also making me want to create my own custom RetroPie project, but that's something that's coming down the pipeline later on. What appeals to me is the fact that you use this controller. That changes everything, because it makes it more authentic. Now, granted, you're going to see, hopefully here, let me change to the gameplay screen here for a second, and I'm going to boot it up. Hopefully, again, it won't crap out on me or give me bad sound. Not on the console side, of course. It's more on the OBS and my capture card, which sometimes with this, okay, so it's working fine. And hopefully the sound won't be too overwhelming. I'm gonna bring it down here for a little bit. Now, as you can see already, there are many different titles here, not of the standard SNES Classic. And of course, to show you guys that I'm actually using the controller, it's hooked on, so it's not something that I'm making up or anything like that. The software used to make this hack is incredibly easy and intuitive, almost to a fault. For me, who I like to tinker around and configure files and do a whole bunch of stuff, it was just too easy. I mean, I've done emulated stuff that's a real pain, but at the same time it's fun, because you get to configure and you get to like work around glitches and stuff like that. But the guy, I think Cluster M is the name of the guy who has this up in the running. The guy's a genius, man. The guy has worked in so many features. I mean, it's so feature rich. Of course, he did started working on this back when the NES Classic came out, so he's had a lot of time to, you know, build and iterate on it. But I know you guys didn't come here for, you know, me gushing over what this person did, and more about the games. So as you can see here, the systems that I added were basically Okay, this is basically the structure, the folder structure that I chose to have on my system, but this is very preliminary because, of course, I am a person who I love to customize my own setups and stuff like that. So since I know there's in the works, if it's not already out there, a feature that allows you to have your own custom music, you know, I'm gonna change the standard one for some heavy metal, I don't know, a track or two. And of course, if there's a way to customize the look of the folders, that would be something. But for the time being, the way I have them is original games in one folder that if I enter, it's going to be basically exactly the same thing that you find standard on the system when you purchase the first time around. So nothing has changed. No games have been sacrificed. If you want to go to the first 21, you can just easily do it. I'm not gonna give too much details on how you do it because there's so many tutorials out there on YouTube that you can search this and find this. But aside from the first 21, you also have in alphabetical order. I wish there's an option. I know that has to be coming up later on, where you can organize the titles by system. That would be nice. But for the time being, what I have is alphabetical order. So as you can see, you're gonna have like the first few characters in order, all the way from numbers to B, C to F, F to L, L to O, P to S, range of S, S to T, T to Z. So that covers the whole lot of games, which I think they're around 261, including the first 21. Now if you go into the first one, you'll find them organized in alphabetical order, like I said. And the first two that I have here is from the Super Graphics and PC Engine, because with the one that I have it, the way I have it configured is that it allows me to play Super NES, Super Famicom, Mega Drive, Japanese version of Genesis, and the American version of Genesis, and of course PC Engine and TurboGrafx-16. So as you can see here, ActRaiser 1 and 2. Now the way that this handles it is very, very cool, because let's say there's a game, from what I understand, ActRaiser 2, that does not work with the standard emulator that the system comes with. It gives it a lot of issue. What it does is it plays it, I'm gonna start it up right here, with the whole settings, just like the normal ones. Now the only difference is you're gonna get the full game, it's gonna be playing flawlessly. It has even the filters that you can add to each and every game, because that's part of the OS, of course. But with this is basically RetroArch, and this is the plugin or add-on that you add to the software that you use to hack the system. And what it does is it installs let's say whatever add-on that you add for whatever system that is giving you trouble. Let's say in this case SNES. Right now it's using the SNES 9X from 2010, 1.41 I believe, and that's what it's using to run this game in particular. So as long as you install, you follow the instructions and install each plugin that you might need. In my case, I installed the TurboGrafx one, I installed one for the Genesis, and of course the backup emulator for the SNES and Super Famicom. That's what that is what allows me to play the Super Famicom games as well. So everything works the way it's supposed to. And I am one. once again, controlling with that SNES pad, which is amazing. Now, later on a later date, I will provide some gameplay, you know, targeted specifically to a game in particular that I want to cover. For now, I'm just gonna try out a few games for you here, because I want to keep the video short. So yeah, ActRaiser 2, which basically takes the first game. I love both of them. This one is more, let's say, action oriented. So you have everything there. Oh, a little bit of glitching going on there. But for the most part, it's in working order. Now, if I reset, I'm going to be thrown back into the menu, from which now we can choose, let's choose a Genesis game. I have TurboGrafx here, haha, Airzonk. And of course, a whole bunch of other titles that of course were missed from the Super Nintendo. This try Alien Soldier, which is one of my favorite treasure games on the Genesis, or in this case the Mega Drive. I'm not sure if it came out for the States though. Is a badass kind of boss rush game type game. Everything here. Yeah, let's do this. I'm not even gonna pick and choose weapons. I just so you see. Oh, where's the shot button? There it goes. I chose the same weapon for all of them. There you go. Yeah, Alien Soldier. Let me get a more well-known. Oh, now this title right here. Bahamut Lagoon. This one came for the Super Famicom, never came stateside, and it's one of the big RPGs that never made it. So let's boot this one up. Again, this one has to be run on the actually I think this one uses the standard emulator, because I'm pressing start and select, which is what you use to bring up the RetroArch menu, and it's not coming up, so more than likely it's using the standard emulator to run it. But as you can hear, it's typical Square Soft music from back in the day. Amazing title. And even though I began playing this a while back, this one is the one that has a fully translated, fan translated, as you saw from the title. So the full game is in English translated. The guys who do this translation, they always, you know, put in really good writing and humor, and it's really enjoyable, the titles that they've done translation, fan translation for. So a title that if you have a chance, find out where you can grab it and give it a try. It's really good. So, moving quickly. Now you're gonna see this is part of the first folder that I showed you guys. Ooh, shoot 'em ups on TurboGrafx. I get a chance to show you how the TurboGrafx work. And we are getting that 80s music. And again, everything works flawless from this controller. Oh yeah, baby. Control yourself, Hatayed. Control yourself, because if not, you're gonna stay here all night playing Blazing Lasers, and I gotta show off the rest of the titles, or at least a couple more. We have, of course, the classic Bonk titles for the TurboGrafx here. Breath of Fire, which is a glaring omission from the standard ones. And let's go into the Super, or the S area of the folders, because of course, let me see, I have Final Fantasies in here. Need to show you something real quick. Final Fantasy V, another one that didn't make it, only in some of the ports that were made for PS1, but here you can actually play the original Super Famicom title. Final Fantasy II, of course, which was missing from the original RPGs on the basic set, with Earthworm Jim 1 and 2, Dragon Spirit, Dragon Quest series, in fully translated as well, a Dragon Ball title thrown into the mix, Donkey Kong Country 2 and 3, yeah, there's a whole bunch of games here. I try to pick and choose as best as I could. Ooh, Contra Hardcore for the Sega Genesis. I try to pick and choose as best as possible, because for the time being, the little chip inside the SNES Mini is a pretty powerful chip, considered what's needed to emulate these titles, 16-bit titles. So it has pretty much enough grunt to manage to play a few good games. I might dare to say that it should be able to play even PlayStation 1 games at a point. But the only problem that it has so far is that it has very limited memory storage. So unless it's being worked in, you have you can't include like the full collection of SNES games, and even less, you know, full collections of other consoles as well. So you have to pick and choose which are your favorite. Like I did in this case, I picked like 30 of the TurboGrafx PC Engine favorites of mine and mixed them with probably 50 or 60 of the Genesis titles, and then the rest SNES. But as you can see, it works really, really well. At this point, even all the features, if I reset it right here, as you can see in the bottom corner, it saved my my snapshot from the title I just booted, which was Contra, and all the features work. See? The suspend point works, everything works fine. If I go into display, I can change from the filter and just leave it and 4:3 to give you, you know, without any of the CRT filtered stuff. And also, you can change the frame to whatever you like, and it still works fine. I'll go back to the point where I left it, and it's gonna play this time with the background that I chose and without the filter. But again, I kind of choose playing with the filter because the filter makes it look a lot less emulated and more original to the console. I gotta remember, what I have to remember here is the layout, because in the case of the Genesis, the layout is A, B, C, and in the case for TurboGrafx is 1 and 2 right here. And I gotta like kind of rethink that every time I pick a console. But yeah, that basically covers that. Later on, I'll have I have more coverage of the titles. I just wanted to give you a quick look, even though it's not so quick because it's already 21 minutes in, but a quick look at how well the hack works and how easy it is to have all of these games in that little tiny beautiful box. That's the SNES Classic. I hope that you guys that were able to get one are able to do this as well. I mean, you're not gonna need a lot of stuff. Everything that you need to do the hack is basically at Cluster M's site. I believe I left the link. I'll leave a link in the description below. But that's gonna be it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Like and subscribe and share with other people, and I'll see you guys soon. Take care.